guys, where should we head next?
Why don't we all split up? We'll clear more ground that way.
Good idea. Okay, let's see. Lauren and Eva, you guys will hit room 401. And Jamie, you'll go with them. You guys will hit the math department.
I still don't understand why we chose whipped cream for the senior prank.
Yeah, I still think we should have gone with raccoons.
Miss Fairley. She's dead.
Hold on. I have an idea. Alrighty now. Detective Lozano and I will stay here and search the body. Detective Basil, Detective Nathaniel, you go out and search for clues, hints, any potential causes of death.
Rough day, eh, Miss Fairley? Sorry.
Fellers, I believe I've found something. It's a fake nail.
My God, is that long?
That's intense.
I would not have chosen that color.
All right, did anyone notice any blood on the body?
Any idea how she died?
Well, there's the cable right there. I reckon she just tripped on it and fell. It's an accident, probably.
Fell over and died? No, sir. This ain't an accident. This here's a murder.
Grade 11 students, this is Detective Theo Simon speaking. There's been an incident, and it appears we have an emergency on our hands. Please put your cream cans down and come to the gym immediately. This is not a drill. I repeat, this is not a drill.
Everybody, listen up. Let's see. Raiden. Mr. Adelman, you're coming with me and Detective Simons.
Mr. Kaufman, you're with Detective Lozano and I.
What the hell is going on?
Where were you at 5:00? We missed you in the cafeteria, little piggy.
I was whipped cream in the history department. You know, the senior prank.
Funny you say that, because we had a little check. In the history room, no cream to be found.
Now where do you reckon all that whipped cream went?
You're dismissed.
So, where were you at 5:00?
I was playing piano in the music room.
I was getting a snack.
Yo no hice nada.
She didn't do anything.
Esto es demasiado injusto.
This is completely unfair.
En mi tierra nunca hacíamos las cosas así.
Back in the motherland, they never did things like this.
Bueno, estúpido, me tenéis que dejar salir de acá, sale.
We were in the learning commons.
I was in Mr. Arthur's classroom, playing chess online.
I was doing the senior prank in the conference room.
Well, sweetie, I was working the cows over yonder.
What are you doing?
We're doing accents, aren't we?
You need to leave.
Where were you at 5:00?
I was whipped creaming in room 401.
I was in the bathroom.
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 I was in the bathroom.
Little birdie told me you might have something against our beloved Miss Fairley.
She was a saint. Bless her heart.
What do you mean, was? What happened to Miss Fairley? And what's up with this accent?
Piggy. So naive.
She
She recently failed you on a math test, didn't she, Miss Alkovitz?
Wasn't my fault. Her notes made no sense. So yeah, I am kind of annoyed.
Where were you at 5 o'clock?
I was with Olivia. We were putting whipped cream in all the outlets on the fourth floor.
Very commendable. May we see your nails, ma'am?
Okay.
You're dismissed.
Oh, yeah. Why are you guys talking with southern accents? Aren't detectives supposed to have, like, New York accents?
We can't do New York accents.
We can't do southern accents either.
I understand that you and Ava were whipping up a storm in the fourth floor power outlets.
Whipping up a... yeah?
Would you care for some sweet tea, darling?
Yeah, thank you so much.
Will you please, detective? How about a blanket? Make yourself comfortable.
Sure.
You ain't getting a damn thing till you tell us what happened to Miss Fairley.
What? What do you mean? What happened to Miss Fairley?
Yeah, detective. What did happen to Miss Fairley?
Nothing. I was just horsing around.
I have no idea what you're talking about, but if something happened to Miss Fairley, something bad, I think I might know who might be involved.
We're all ears, darling.
Well, the other day I was texting Bianca. She seemed really angry about Miss Fairley. I can show you if you want.
What the?
Evidence, it's important. You know you're really not supposed to have that.
The new phone policy, phase 4, no phones allowed.
I hear it's gone nationwide. Good cop, bad cop. Listen, Bianca, we're your friends. We're here to help you.
Explain yourself, Piggy!
Wait, did Olivia show you this? I promise I didn't actually mean any of what I said. I only said it because Miss Fairley made a joke about me in front of the whole class, and I talked to her about it, and she didn't even say sorry. She just laughed. But it's okay. I don't really have anything against her. I didn't mean to hurt her feelings. I just didn't know what to say. Please don't tell her.
Okay. May we see your nails?
You're free to go, ma'am.
So, where were you at 5 o'clock?
I was playing with my water bottle. See?
So, where were you at 5 o'clock?
I was running the operation in the cafeteria, remember?
I was in the cafeteria.
I was directing the grad video.
I was whipped creaming the fitness center.
Her nails.
What are you guys even talking about?
At approximately 5 p.m. today, we found Miss Fairley dead in the math department. And right next to her body, just so happened to be your blindingly vibrant, horrifically green nail.
Wait, Miss Fairley's dead?
Look who finally decided to start paying attention. Like Cinderella lost her shoe at the ball, you lost your nail at the crime scene. How convenient. It's her, Detective. I see it in her eyes.
Go easy, Detective. I want to hear her story. What were you doing at the math department, Miss Heine?
I was just going over my work with Mr. Cinquemani. It must have come off when I was putting my papers away. I don't know anything about a murder.
She's lying. She's lying and it's clear as day.
Go easy, Detective. What are you doing? Look at her. She's composed. Don't you reckon she would be squirming in her seat by now?
I swear it. I swear it on my life. There's no other option. There's no other way. There's no... Damn it, Detective, it's her! Can't you see that?
You're dismissed, Miss Haney.
Now what the hell do you think you're doing?
Miss Haney, you are dismissed. Go home.
You're letting the killer go free? Detective, why?
You're sweating, Jamie.
Detective Lozano, you are deliberately sabotaging our entire operation.
Just stop with the accent, please. Just for a second.
We're detectives. This is how detectives talk, and I hardly think letting the killer go free...
She's not the killer, Jamie. I think you know that. Here, have a seat. Sit with me. Can I ask you something, Jamie? Look, when we first opened the door to the math department and we saw Miss Fairley's body, I think we were all trying to play it off, right? I mean, I acted like everything was under control, but really, I could barely breathe. Did you get that feeling too?
Yeah. I did.
And you know, just as well as I do, our detective characters, our accents, it's kind of like a defense mechanism. Right? It is. Because, to be honest, Jamie, I'm scared, man. Aren't you? Aren't you scared? Jamie, did you kill Miss Fairley? Was it you?
I swear, it was just an accident. I swear it. We just wanted to get our math exam answers. And so we went into the math department and then she...
She? Who is she?
I can't say. She told me not to say.
Help me out, Jamie. Who was it?
It was Eva. You see, Eva and I, we have these scholarships. We're gonna go to school together next year. And if we failed the math exams, we'd lose it all. So she had this idea that we'd sneak into the math office after school and we'd take our answers. But when she opened that door, Miss Fairley was there. She was about to leave. But Eva got startled and she pushed Miss Fairley over a cable where she tripped, she fell and she hit her head on the floor. It was all an instant.
Why didn't you come to us earlier?
I wanted to. I swear, but Eva kept saying, insisting that if anyone found out what we did, it would ruin our lives. I mean, forget the scholarships. We could go to jail for this. If it was just me, I would have gone to you straight away. But Eva's whole life could be over now that I've told you this. I just want to protect her.
I have to go to the police, Jamie. You understand that, right?
Tell them I did it. I'll take the blame.
Stay here.
So, Miss Rabica, Eva, where were you at 5 o'clock?
I was upstairs with Jamie.
You mean to tell us you were with our very own Detective Nathaniel? He can vouch for you?
Yeah. Didn't he already tell you where I was?
No, ma'am. No, he did not.
Well, ask him. He'll tell you the truth.
Where exactly were you with Jamie, Miss Rabikov?
I told you. We were upstairs, room 401.
Look, Eva. No need to be hostile. We already know about you and Jamie.
You do?
Don't fret, darling. Our lips are sealed.
Safe and sound.
You won't arrest me?
Arrest you for what? Love?
Honey, we're looking for a murderer, not a high school romance.
Oh, well, me and Jamie have some
issues. Issues that need resolving.
Honey, we all have issues.
In no time, you lovebirds will be singing in the sun.
Fly, birdie, fly.
Detectives, follow me.
Where's Detective Nathaniel?
He's in our interrogation room.
We were in the middle of an interrogation. What's the matter?
I know who the killer is. It's Miss Rabakov. Eva.
I beg your pardon?
Detective Nathaniel told me he was there. He witnessed everything.
Detective Nathaniel and Miss Rabakov were together?
Liars, the both of them. They're at the math department where Eva had accidentally killed Miss Fairley. They were trying to get their math exam answers. Miss Fairley was about to leave. Eva got startled and pushed her over to a cable where she tripped and hit her head.
So Jamie's been lying this whole time.
No. It makes sense. Remember? Eva and Jamie, they came back from the calf and they said...
Okay, guys. Where should we head next?
They were talking about the senior prank, right? Except... they weren't holding any whipped cream cans.
They hadn't gone to 401. They went to the math department.
And Jamie was feeling really bad after what Eva had done.
But they have scholarships. Miss Fairley's death would wreck their future.
So she's been keeping him quiet. Making sure he doesn't confess.
And that's why he's been shifting the focus towards the nail evidence he knew would turn the suspicion away from them.
Should we call the police?
I assume so.
You're right, Detective Lozano.
Jamie's real sorry.
That doesn't matter if he's concealing a murder.
Well, Eva wouldn't let him confess. He's awfully passionate about her.
Feelings mutual. We were just interrogating her, and she seemed really smitten with him.
Oh, you just say you're interrogating Eva right now?
Oh dear, I hope their relationship isn't affected by Jamie's confession.
We need to leave now.
No, we have to warn the others.
Hey, you guys get out of here. Keep it up in the gym. Hey! Everyone, hello! We all need to exit the building right now.
Let's go.
Just please, just listen to me. We all need to leave right now, okay? Come on. Guys!
It won't open.
What do you mean it's not opening?
The janitor probably locked us in thinking we were leaving.
Hey! What's going on here?
Hudson, look.
You've kept us here for 2 hours. What the hell have you guys been doing?
Come on, we all just want to go home.
Do you realize how late it is? It's locked.
Why would the door be locked?
And why are you guys acting so weird? Yeah, where did your accents go?
And where is Jamie?
Isn't he supposed to be with you guys?
There's no time to explain.
Yes, listen, do any of you have your phones?
No, we have to leave them at home now.
Anyway!
Oh, I left it in the interrogation room.
Everybody go upstairs now. Go now, come on!
It's dead.
What do we do?
We need to get back up there.
Oh my god, that's them. They're the ones that murdered Jamie! Ah!
What's been going on for the last 2 hours?
Is Jamie really dead?
No! No way. I know he's not.
I don't know about this. I really don't know.
Cammy, Jamie is fine. We have to stick together. You know we'll get through this. Like always.
Yeah, come on. We should be safe in here for now.
We have to find a way out of here. There must be some kind of escape, something they missed.
It's okay, let's just think for a second.
It's locked.
Maybe we could jump off the balcony or climb through a window?
Inshallah, but they're all locked. Plus we're 3 stories up. None of us could try that jump.
We're trapped. If we want to make it out of here alive, we're gonna have to fight for it.
Follow me.
We're outnumbered. We need to stay hidden close.
Hold on. Hold on. This has to be some sort of misunderstanding. Why would they kill him?
He wouldn't cooperate. They'd all been planning on it for weeks. You know how they locked us into the gym and called on us one by one? It was a trap. You get called, you get murdered. Like a slaughterhouse. And their suits and accents, just distractions. And I got called up and Jamie, he couldn't do it. No, he wouldn't do it. Not to me. And so they made me watch while they murdered Jamie. I escaped before they could get to me, too.
I'm so sorry, Eva. Are you sure you saw all that?
Of course I'm sure! Sorry. I feel like you aren't believing me. I saw it. I swear to you, I saw it.
We believe you.
Of course we believe you.
But you don't just suddenly become a serial killer. I mean, these people were our friends. I don't know what happened to them. They were nice. They were kind. They were normal.
I can't get the image out of my head. Jamie, I can still hear his screams echoing. It's ringing in my ears. And his warmth and his beautiful eyes looking up at me as he faded away. I can sense him. I can still sense him here with me.
What's that music? I don't know. Should we go check?
I don't.
Yeah, let's go check.
Let's go.
Let's keep our voices.
I wonder what happened to everyone that got called into the theater.
All we can do is hope that they're safe.
Ah!
Come on, be quiet.
Get off.
Shut up and listen, please. Please listen.
Look, you've got it all wrong.
Screw you, you killed Jamie.
Hey, would you listen for 1 second? Okay? You guys don't know anything. I don't know what Eva told you.
She said you killed Jamie.
She's obviously lying. There's no way you believe that.
Then what's your explanation?
She murdered Jamie and blamed it on us.
Hey, would you all shut up about that? Jamie isn't dead. And if he was, which he isn't, Eva would be the last person to do that. They've been hanging out all year. You all sound unhinged.
I know he was your best friend, Hudson, but...
Where is he?
We really should get out of here. The theater should be...
Give me an explanation!
If we tell you everything, can we go? Can we find the others? We're not safe yet. Well, it all started with Miss Fairley.
Did you guys make it out of your interrogation?
What?
You know, your interrogation with the detectives.
Are you okay? How'd you make it out?
Make it out of what? Theo and Lindy just took me into a sketchy closet and just asked me a bunch of strange questions.
So there wasn't a slaughterhouse? They didn't try to kill you?
What? No, they just asked me where I was at 5 o'clock. Are you guys okay?
Her story was fake. Of course it was fake.
But we just saw Jamie's...
Look, Ryan, you need to come with us. You're not safe here.
Hey, it's not us!
We know.
It's Eva.
Yeah, we know. She's been lying. Wait, where
is Eva? She was just here.
We don't know.
Eva's not here?
Why would she be here?
Why is Raiden here?
Can someone clue me in?
Eva killed Jamie.
And before that, she killed Miss Fairley.
But that was an accident.
Eva and Jamie were trying to get their math exam answers.
That's the whole reason why we became detectives.
Jamie was a witness, and she wanted to cover it up.
Did you say Miss Fairley is dead?
Jamie too?
You are all so behind on this.
We were with Eva here. She was acting insane. We heard Raiden on the piano and left. I thought she'd be here. Where is she? You okay, Hudson?
Guys, we need a plan. She could be anywhere. Eva!
It was Eva!
You promised.
Explain yourselves.
No. I'm done explaining ourselves.
Well, you're gonna have to.
We promise. Fine. Everyone grab a weapon.
Hey!
Hey everyone, we're sorry about today, our whole detective act.
We may have gotten a little bit carried away.
Look, I understand we were all suspects, but did you really have to lock us all in the gym?
Well, we couldn't risk one of you escaping.
And I mean, it worked.
It did not work.
Well, we found out it was Eva.
After she killed Jamie.
Yeah, well, I want to talk about how you all thought we were murderers. You all just believed her.
Eva was really convincing.
Henri, how long have I known you?
Come on, so much was happening.
How long?
You were acting suspicious all day.
Also, like Angela said, you locked us in the gym for hours.
Hey. You all need to stop bickering. No phones. Doors are locked. Windows too. We're just gonna have to wait it out.
Wait till the morning.